I'm Antonio Graceffo. It's Martial Arts Odyssey. We're back in Burma at the Shan State Army headquarters, and I'm back with my very good friend, Sergeant Sai Kong. Today we're going to be talking about knife fighting, some very basic knife fighting. Now, the best rule on knife fighting is don't fight with knives. But if it comes up, okay, maybe we can learn a few techniques, how we can defend and how we can escape. But at the end of the day, the best rule on knives is run away or pick up a stick, a rock, or a gun and take care of that situation. All right, so we're going to talk about some basic knife fighting today. A lot of this, if you studied RNS, or if you studied Kali, or some of the Filipino arts, you'll recognize some of these moves. Sergeant Sai Kong has also taught me a few of the Lai Dai moves, which belong to the Shan people. Shan people invented a kind of kung fu called Lai Dai, because they belong to the Thai ethnic group, and he's going to show us a few of those moves too. All right, so here we go. This is a basic strike to the head. And look what I'm doing. I'm blocking with my hand open, but I'm blocking with my blade at the same time. And once I've blocked, I'm gonna drag my blade right across his wrist. Okay, from here, I can grab. I can come across here to the midsection. I can come across here under the armpit. Or I can stab under the armpit. Stab someone under the armpit, they're gonna bleed to death. Okay, so he's gonna drag. It's gonna cut. He can stab. Yeah. Okay, stab right here. All right, the next one. Somebody stabs at your midsection. Now, you got a choice. You can block out or in. You're going to block out. Why? We push the blade away from us. If he's still moving with his weight, it's going to go past us, not going to hurt us. So we block, and once again, we always want to have our blade with our block. So we block with our blade, jerk down like this. We're going to cut, and we're in exactly the same position. We can cut here, under the armpit, we can stab. We can grab hold here, or you pull him into a basic thrust. Okay, more advanced striking technique. I can bring my blade up from underneath, right through the groin, right up through the body. Okay, we can also bring the blade down on the head. Another technique, we can use the butt of the weapon. Maybe we don't want to kill this opponent, we just want to subdue him. We're subduing an opponent, use the butt of the weapon as a hook, grab his head. Okay, those of you who've studied Muay Thai, right? Most people know that's the basis of my fighting is Muay Thai. I like to grab the back of the head. We can actually do that with the butt of the knife. I can use my body weight to pull him down. I've pretty much got control of him at this point. From here, I can come up with a knee to the face, or I can step in. I can put his knife behind his body, and now I've got control of him. I can use the hook once again, pull the knife up his back. He's gonna be forced to let go at that point. I can secure it in this position. And here, I can press against the flat of the blade, take it right out of his hand, okay? The other thing I can do is I can do a knockout. I can hit him in the back of the head with the butt of my weapon. Okay, he strikes at me, I block. I can step in here with the butt, right to the temple. Butt to the jawbone, butt to the jaw. I can punch. I can punch like this, kind of a hook. I'm using the butt of the weapon. These are all non-lethal ways of subduing somebody. Yeah, without killing him, right? That's non-lethal. All right, the next thing, we can grab here. We can always use the butt of the weapon to grab. And you can always apply pressure to the elbow the wrong way. So those of you who've studied Hapkido, you know a lot of techniques like that. Still do them even with a knife. Another thing we can do after we've blocked, we can go under. From here, I can use my blade to force him to bend his arm, force him to stab himself. I can take my blade out, I can use both my hands, force him to stab himself. I can use my blade to get control, put his blade behind his back again, and I can take him down. Sai Kong's going to show us some of his techniques from his Lai Thai, Shan martial art. Okay, so he's grabbed, he's got control of my knife, and he's grabbed my throat. And if you see his leg is in a good position to knock me down. Wah! Okay, pull me right into a knee strike. Pull me right into a knee strike. And you can bend my arm. Ah, and look at what he's doing. He's pressing on my elbow to get control. And the knife is going right into my googlies. Okay, if you're at home, don't let the knife go in your googlies. Now, he's put his weight on my knee and he's bringing me down to the ground. I'm tied up like a pretzel. Pretzel of barbed wire. Ah, got my arm behind my back. I'm completely off balance. If you don't have a weapon, now as a rule, someone comes at you with a knife and you're barehanded, you're at a severe disadvantage. As a rule, I don't believe any of these techniques will work, but I teach them because that's how I make a living. Somebody comes at you with a knife and you're barehanded, get away. Or grab whatever you can and use it as a weapon. We're on a pretty dusty field right here. I could grab some sand, throw it in his face. I could kick him and run away. Don't become Bruce Lee and try and take him to the ground, but if you absolutely have to, then defend yourself. If he comes at me, if you're familiar with Hapkido, you can either block outside, you block outside here, we can grab. Now I can do all my Hapkido techniques. Do this one, you can do this one. I can grab the arm here, I can break it. Anything you would normally do in Hapkido or anything you would normally do in grappling, you can do with a knife in your hand or without a knife in your hand. Why? I absolutely love Philippine martial art because they do all the same techniques with the empty hand, they do with the blade or they do with the stick. That's it for knife fighting this week. Thank you again, Sergeant Saikon. And we'll see you next time on Martial Arts Odyssey. I'm Antonio Graceffo. Get in the gym, do your sets, do your reps, do your road work. But please, say a prayer for the people of Burma.
One, two, three, four.